Hi there folks, welcome back. Okay, today's video is a Q&A day. Yes. But before we get on with that, I'd like to give a massive, massive shout out and congratulations to YouTube channel Ant on a Slant. Yes, it is a biker YouTube channel. I'm not going to rabbit on about his content. I want you guys and girls to go and check it out for yourself. And if you like his content, hit that subscribe button and maybe congratulate him on that 1,000 subscriber mark. Yeah, a bit of encouragement. Yeah. There's a lot of biker YouTube channels have disappeared over the last couple of years. So I want to encourage people to go and support the ones that are still around, okay, the ones that I think turn out good content. And Ant on the Slant turns out some great content, so please go across and show him some support. 1,000 subscribers, well done. Yeah, I know that feeling when you first break that, and that feeling you get, yes, 1,000. Yeah, it is like a landmark for a lot of YouTubers. Yeah, right, okay, that being said, one of the questions that comes in on my Q&As is about my dream bike. Now, I've done a video with three bikes I'd like to own, yeah, and all the bikes that I've really wanted to own, I've actually owned. But a dream bike, I've never really thought about it too much until I saw a documentary featuring Keanu Reeves, his business partner, and their motorcycle company called Arch Motorcycles. They build custom motorcycles to the customer's specification. Yeah, now after watching that, if I was to have a dream bike, it would have to be something built to my specification by that company. When you go and watch the footage, I'll put some links to it. I think you'll understand why, yeah, I would want a company like that building my dream bike. Yeah, I'll leave the links down in the description. So also that comes in questions is what things am I interested in outside of motorcycles and motorcycle clubs? Well, I've got a lot of interests. One of my big interests is history. Now, I don't know whether it's something to do with genetics, whether it's, DNA deep, but as I was growing up, I was totally surrounded by grandparents and great-grandparents that were historians themselves. My mum's father was a serious historian. Anything to do with World War I, World War II, any conflicts throughout the world, that guy on his bookshelf had books about it. I could spend hours scanning through his bookshelves for different books about history and different people in history. I kind of really missed, his library. It was an incredible library. But then on my father's side, my grandfather on my dad's side was a massive, massive history buff himself with another incredible library. It would take weeks literally to go through and read all the different titles that he had in his library. He had absolutely everything you could think of in his library, from storybooks right the way through to history books. It was a massive library. Even books on religions, different religions, everything. If I needed a book and I couldn't get it anywhere else, I knew that I could get it from him. My great-great-grandfather on my dad's side was a history professor, so I guess, it's got to be something that's genetic, I think, because, friends of mine have even said, you're a real freak in the head for history. And it is, I'm like a sponge when it comes to history. So that is a massive, massive interest of mine. So is politics, because politics and history are all mixed. Yeah, especially when you look at some of the history that I was reading at my granddad's houses, like my mum's side of the family, with all those different types of books that he had. So yeah, that's that. My other big, big interest is, and I was born in the very, very early years of 1960s. And I was born and raised in what we used to call the space age. Yeah, or the age of the space race to get on the moon first. So I grew up with all that stuff. So I've always had a really, really big interest in engineering, avionics engineering. That's what I became later in life, an avionics engineer. But I've always had this interest in space travel, rocketry, all this type of stuff. I've always had a big interest in it. So That's where one of my big interests lays, yeah. Space travel, I'm very fascinated by it. Anything to do with space and space travel. And in saying that, I'm going to mention another YouTube channel, yeah. I might give people a bit of an idea of, you know, why I'm really interested in all this stuff, because it does have a history angle to it as well. I remember my dad waking us kids up and saying, "Come on, boys, you know, we're going to go and watch on the BBC, we're going to watch man land on the moon." And, you know, I looked at my dad, he said, "This is very important, you know. You are going to be part of the history that is made today, because you're going to be watching it happen. You will be part of history." And it was kind of put the pieces together. Yes, we are part and parcel, yeah, of history. Yeah, any historical event that happens during our lifetimes, technically we are part of that historical event. Yeah, and for me, space and everything else is major. It's big interest to me. The other question that comes in is, what sort of programs, films and stuff do I like? Well, I don't actually own a television. I haven't owned a television for best part of 11 years, but I do have an interest. Again, it goes back to sci-fi, space travel, all this type of stuff, yeah. I just absolutely love it. Now, I'm not over keen on the modern remakes of some of the old classics. So if I said Battlestar Galactica, yeah, I wasn't so taken in, you know, with the newer series, but the old original, yeah, religiously watched it. Okay, I still go back, yeah, and watch the old original Battlestar Galactica over the new one any day of the week. Yeah, I was also a massive fan. I've got all the collection of Space 1999. And I am a massive fan of Stargate, you know, the Stargate franchise. I've got absolutely all of it. I'm a massive Stargate fan. When it comes to movies and stuff, I'm more stuck in the past with movies like 2001, A Space Odyssey, that type of stuff. Yeah, that's the kind of genre that I like when it comes to sci-fi and all that. I do like horror movies, but I tend to go more with sci-fi, yeah, and sci-fi that is, you know, in relation to space travel, visiting other planets, all that type of stuff. That's the kind of thing that I'm really into, you know, outside in my life, outside of what I do here on YouTube and the biker and biker community and all the rest of it. I was also asked, and this one coming quite a lot, especially after my trip to Israel, am I religious? Am I a religious person? I'm a spiritual person, yeah. Yes, I have a Coptic cross on my arm. I had the cross put on my arm when I was 13 years old originally. And when I went to Israel, I visited Jerusalem and had a Coptic cross put on my arm, the same Coptic cross as what was on my dad's arm, my granddad and my great granddad and my great great granddad. My dad was born from a woman that was half English, but her mum was Sephardi, so she's Jewish. So my dad took the Jewish line. My great great grandmother on my dad's side also was Jewish. So we've got a bit of a mix of Judaism and Christianity all the way through the family. But I went down the road of with my grandfather and my great great grandfather that I went my great great grandfather, should I say. And my great grandfather, I went down that road with that they went down with the Coptic. Do I believe in what's written in the Bible and the Quran and all the rest of it? Well, I have actually studied Islam, Sunni and Shia. I dated a Muslim. I've studied Judaism. I did a 3-year Bible course to study Christianity, and I came out of the other side with the idea of words that are written in books carry the same weaknesses, the same egos and everything as the people that wrote those words down. I do believe there's a creator, okay? I do believe there's a creator, and it doesn't matter what name you use, yeah, whether it be Yahweh, Allah. It doesn't matter. Those words, yeah, are the words for the same creator, one creator. That is it. That's what I believe in. I'm not here to debate about religion. People have asked me what I believe in, and my beliefs are, yeah, I don't believe the words of men created by men to control other men, but I do pull more towards my great grandfather and my great great grandfather's line, the Coptic line, and I do believe there's a creator, but I don't believe in what's written in books by men. Okay, I hope that one clears that one up. I am a spiritual person more than anything else. And that is pretty much what I'm going to touch on today. And I'm going to close this video, yeah, because I didn't mention that video, that channel that I was going on about when I was talking about space. I got a little bit... if you want to see the kind of thing that I mean when I say I'm interested in the space race and the, you know, the era that I grew up in, there's a brilliant YouTube channel out there. Yeah, I'm going to give it a shout. And it's called Vintage Space. I'll put a link to it down in the description. There you can get an idea of the sort of thing that I watch on YouTube and that when I'm not watching bikery stuff. Last but no means least. Okay. My t-shirt competition. What I'm going to do is I'm actually going to pick the winners while I'm in Israel. I'm off to Israel in April. So I'm going to pick the winners. But I am going to tell you today what number is the winner. Yeah. So those of you that picked number one, that the first place people I visited when I was in Israel, obviously I'm not counting the club that I actually stayed with, because that would be just way too obvious. But the first group of people, place I visited, was the night after I arrived. We went off and we visited FTW Pilots MC up in Tel Aviv for a private party. So those of you that picked number one, yeah, keep your eyes and ears peeled for when I'm in Israel, because I'm going to get a couple of people over there, yeah, to randomly pick a couple of numbers, and it'll be those people that will win the t-shirts, okay? So that's when I'm going to draw it, when I'm out there. Anyway, so if you pick number one, congratulations. You will now be going forward, yeah, to the next step of picking a winner out of all of you people that picked number one. And there were a hell of a lot of you, okay? That's why I let it run for a little while longer, because there were still people, you know, entering that little competition. That's why I let it run for that little while longer. But now it's closed. Winner is number ones. Anyone that picked number one will now go forward. Yeah, and we will pick two winners, yeah, who will win those t-shirts. Anyway, I hope that's answered all your questions. If you've got any more questions you'd like me to delve into, drop them in the description below and they will go forward to my next Q&A day. You all stay safe and I'll catch you later.